We've celebrated a first here at the Payload Operations Integration Center. For the first time, two researchers were able to connect with astronauts at the same time that their experiments were being performed. Now, that may not sound like a big deal, but it is a big deal. And the person who has to facilitate that is called a Payload Communicator, or a PAYCOM, here in the POIC. And Stacy Jones joins me now. She is a PAYCOM. And Stacy, first of all, tell us what a PAYCOM does.
Well, a PAYCOM serves as the link between the ground teams, that's the scientists and our other flight controllers. We serve as a link to them and to the astronauts on board.
It's a very important job, but now it's a little busier, right?
It is. So we're responsible for the real-time voice communication on the International Space Station. And previously, there had only been two space-to-ground audio channels that we shared with six crew members on board and then amongst five control centers on the ground.
Wow. So now you have four channels, and these investigators are very excited about this, right?
Not only the investigators, we're all really excited. As you can imagine, it was tough to share all of those resources. So with the addition of the KU-COM unit on board, once the guys installed the hardware, which was only days before this experiments ran, we actually were able to double our capacity for audio channels. So instead of two, we now have space to grounds three and four added. In addition, we also had two extra video channels. It's really always nice to get to follow along with the crew and see what they're doing instead of just talking to them.
Let's talk a little bit about the experiments that were performed that day.
Okay. To begin, we had CFE, which is a capillary flow experiment whose aim is to work with different wetting angles and to develop, in the end, better spacecraft fuel and fuel tanks so that in hopes that we can improve our abilities to get us to Mars.
And then the other one, we're talking about fire, right?
Yeah, we got to work with fire. The astronauts always really enjoy both of those. But it was the BASS experiment, the burning and suppressions of solids in space. And what they want to do is basically take a lot of different materials and prove that they burn as well as, if not better than, they would in normal gravity as they do in microgravity under the same identical conditions.
So while these guys are talking to the astronauts, you guys are just kicked back, right?
You would think so. And it does take a lot of the pressure off of us because, as you can imagine, we work 24/7 and there's always something for our teams to do. But we pay very close attention and make sure that things are going well because our PAYCOMs are always the crew advocate. So we want to make sure things are going well for them up there. And in addition, maybe they lost an item or maybe there's something else that the team there in Huntsville can help with that the scientists may not have access to.
Why is it so important that these researchers speak directly with the astronauts?
Well, the PAYCOMs are trained, and we work with the crew to build rapport so that we know what they expect, the language they use, so that we can communicate with them as best we can. But sometimes you have such intricate and really fast-paced experiments when you're dealing with fluid shifting and when you're dealing with fire, it makes better sense to enable those principal investigators so that they can provide that instantaneous answer instead of going through another link and delaying the answer by maybe seconds, which is critical for those experiments.
And your job is critical, and I know that you even traveled to Europe to train folks there.
Yes, I actually was the first female and first lady on the EuroCom team, and I got to work at the European Astronaut Center for almost 4 years doing the same job, and it was such a pleasure to come back here to Huntsville, my hometown, and get to work with some of the friendly faces. And I have to give special thanks to Carol Wagner, the lady who was by my side that day, and she helped make sure that everything went smooth. So
awesome. You always make things smooth. Thank you so much, Stacy.
Thanks, Lori.